The Philippine Supreme Court disqualifies some bar examinees for allegedly violating the Honor Code. In a bulletin released Sunday, Supreme Court Associate Justice and Bar Chairperson Marvick Leonin said his office received reports of some examinees who deliberately entered examination sites despite testing positive for COVID. He added some examinees brought mobile phones inside examination rooms and accessed social media during lunch break. The disqualification only applies for the recent examinations. Meanwhile, over 200 bar examinees were unable to take the exams after testing positive for COVID. Thousands of law graduates from 2020 and 2021 batches took the two-day bar exams last week after being postponed numerous times due to the pandemic. Vice presidential candidate Sara Duterte Carpio not entertaining thoughts of possibly replacing her running mate, presidential bet Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., who is facing disqualification cases. Duterte Carpio says she finds the discussion unpleasant and presumptuous. The Davao mayor also says she hasn't talked about it with Marcos. That's as she insists the disqualification cases against him are baseless. Marcos Jr. previously said in an interview that should he win the presidency and get disqualified, he would want to have Duterte Carpio as his replacement, assuming that she also wins the elections. The so-called unit team has been topping recent surveys. An election watchdog expresses dismay over the supposed delay in the release of the Election Commission's decision on the disqualification cases against Bongbong Marcos. Contradaya convener Danilo Araw says this should have been resolved sooner since all the necessary information about the case are already with the COMELEC. He adds COVID-19 is not a justified excuse for not penning the decision.
Talagang dapat managot yung dapat managot. At particular dito, yung ponensya, si Commissioner Ferolino, dahil talagang nag-vaccinate talaga siya sa kanitong klaseng mahalagang task.
The head of the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee explains why Senator Bongo was not named in his partial report of the government's supposedly overpriced pandemic supply deals with Farmily Pharmaceutical. That's despite Go's ties to those who have been recommended by the panel to be charged, including Health Secretary Francisco Duque, former budget official Christopher Lau, and several Farmily executives. Senator Richard Gordon says they found no direct link between the administration senator and the highly controversial deal.
He's been close to all these people. These are all Davao folks. These are all during the campaign of the president. In this country, no one gets appointed without going through Bongo. From judges, justices, nakikiusap yan kay Bongo. Hindi ko na sinama si Bongo. He's a member of the Senate, and I have really no proof except the fact that they were associated with him. That is not proof. But when you make hukay later on, you don't know kono lalabas.
Gordon says he's still waiting on three senators to support his role or report on the Farmily probe. He also again slammed other government agencies for still failing to act on the issue despite all the evidence his committee has gathered.
They refuse to allow us to follow the money. We cannot open their bank accounts. The silence of the Money Laundering Council is deafening, and the government is just watching. Actually, in America, if this is going on, the Department of Justice would have acted right away based on the evidence. The Ombudsman would have acted on the evidence. Pero itong bansa natin, from day one, palaging nangingilay pagka presidente ang involved. Bakit? And that is why we do not have closure in this country.
In other news, the camp of embattled religious leader Pastor Apollo Quiboloy questions the timing of the release of a most wanted poster of him by the U.S. Federal Bureau of Investigation. The self-proclaimed Son of God and spiritual advisor of President Rodrigo Duterte is currently facing raps of sex trafficking of children and bulk cash smuggling in the U.S. But his lawyer believes his inclusion in the most wanted list is just America's way of trying to influence the Philippine elections.
Has not been interfering with our elections since as far as we can remember. Bakit po Noong hindi pa Pangulo si Pangulong Duterte, ay wala naman po kayong naririnig ng mga ganitong akusasyon laban kay Pastor Quiboloy. The only logical reason here is that they are using the closeness of Pastor Quiboloy with President Duterte para gibain indirectly.
Quiboloy's camp also denies he is currently in hiding. He was last seen in public last week as he prayed over the tandem of Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte Carpio. The pastor also had an online sermon Saturday night wherein he likened his situation to a biblical figure.
Tingnan ninyo ang dinaanan niya, puro tribulation. Yan si Joseph. At merong modern Joseph ngayon. Bago matupad ang lahat ng ipinangako ng Ama sa akin, ang lahat ng ito ay dadaanan ng anak.
The Philippine Justice Department vows to follow due process should the U.S. ask for Quiboloy's extradition. That's despite the close ties between the pastor and President Duterte. Once the U.S. requests for extradition, Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara says that would still have to undergo the country's own legal process before it is allowed.
Pag natanggap namin yung request, gagawin namin yung aming trabaho ng naaayon sa batas at sa proseso na ginagawa namin sa departamento, regardless kung sino yung mga personalidad na involved.
Quiboloy's camp meanwhile maintains they are not asking for any special favors from the chief executive.
There is no need to. We have laws here, and as long as those laws are faithfully complied with, in the matter of a petition for extradition, should there be one, yun na po ang aming tutuparin. There is a process, and if the court say that he has to be extradited, then we will follow what the law says.